the Estadio da Luz. This is Peter Drury, and next to me providing insights will be Jim Beglin.
Thanks, Peter. It's a pleasure and a privilege for me to be here.
Now it's Mitroglou. Mitroglou with the ball through. Well, that's where he wants it. Salvio. On the right now. What's on? Salvio looking up to see who wants it. The pass cuts it out. Luisao. Mitroglou. Jonas!
Saved only by poor finishing. I think he's done very well to get into such a good position in front of the goal, but he just couldn't put in the telling touch.
Jonas, now it's Mitroglou. The defence can get it clear. Salvio on a strong run down the right. He slid it through. Gets it back. It's come loose. Here comes another cross. Goal! Benfica!
Unbelievable.
And how about that for a volley, executed to perfection?
Well, I thought it was very well worked down the right side, but don't underestimate the volley. They can be a difficult skill.
Benfica take the lead.
Well, that's put him in the driving seat, but there's a lot of football left in this one yet, believe me.
It's been intercepted, and that will come to nothing. So, they got the only goal to make it 1-0. And he's made sure that that won't get through. Intercepted, really alert to the danger. Benfica are leading with half-time drawing close. Looks like a good ball through. And he's through on goal. Oh, and they really should have been made to pay. Oh, that's great stuff. Exactly what he's all about.
I think what we're looking at here is just a very special talent.
someone who can decide the outcome of a match on his own.
Luisao.
Well played, he saw that coming. Coaxed out to the wing. Now here's the through ball. Corner then. And out to safety. Çoğlu cuts it back. And that's been repelled. Away from immediate danger. We hit half-time.
Well, they've shown glimpses of some wonderful football to go in with the lead at half-time, and that's definitely pleased the fans. I think they'll be looking to keep this intensity up now in the second half.
Benfica going to have the lead in a tight old game. Half-time, 1-0.
Start of another 45 minutes.
Benfica
carry a one-goal lead into the second half.
Now it's Mitroglou. Mitroglou brings the ball forward.
Oh, he's broken through. It's broken loose.
Benfica ahead here by what is still the only goal. Throw it.
That's not going to go down too well with his teammates. Lobs it in gently. Here it comes. He's had a shot! The ball's come loose and the chase is on. And that's left him on the seat of his pants.
Eliseu.
It's a good run down the left-hand side. Passes it through.
Now it's Salvia.
Looks to slip it through. He's off on a marauding run. Tries a through ball.
Benfica made a substitution yet.
And the flag has stayed down. And he's there to cut it out. Loose ball. And the finish! Oh, taken with style!
Well, that's something that'll make the manager proud, because they dug in deep then and they've got their leveller.
Wow, he was never going to miss from there.
Well, for me, that's just pure predatory brilliance. It's not so much the finish, but the way he read the situation when nobody else was even alert to it. It's fantastic.
That has added a whole new complexion to the game.
Well, that goal just serves to give them the momentum and psychological edge now at this stage, but for me, they've got to chase a winner.
Just 5 minutes remaining now.
settling for what they have because they're not going to score from there.
Tries to get it forward quickly.
The final whistle. Passion and panache and perseverance, and in the end, parity. A really good game to watch.
So, Jim, how do you reflect on what we've seen?
Listen, the more this game went on, a draw was always likely to be on the card. So, overall, I don't think anyone will be complaining too much about what they've got.
All that remains for me is to...